Welcome friends, a new lecture. In last lecture, we learn about trade discount. Trade discount is the artificial matter. Amount equal to trade discount already added by seller. At the time of deal, it is deducted by seller and therefore it is not a loss for seller. And it is not a gain for purchaser. It is 100% artificial matter and therefore no accounting treatment of trade discount in the books of purchaser and seller according to rule. Now in next point, today we are going to start cash discount. Our new point, cash discount. Limitation of credit transaction means recovery from customer. It is horrible. Buy credit sales. Investment in working capital increase. By credit sale, seller is responsible to bear interest expense in investment. It is problem for seller. For solution of this problem, for encouragement of cash transaction, whenever a special discount provided by seller to customer on cash payment, on cash transaction only, and it is known as a cash discount. Remember, cash discount chargeable on original value, real value of goods, and therefore whenever cash discount charge, it becomes loss for seller and profit for customer. Because cash discount chargeable on real value of goods. It's a real matter, real discount, and therefore accounting treatment of cash discount is necessary in the books of seller and purchaser both. Cash discount provided by seller to customer to encourage cash transaction. Therefore, remember this, cash discount chargeable only on cash transaction, not on credit transaction. Trade discount chargeable on both transaction, cash transaction and credit transaction, but cash discount only chargeable on cash transaction. Now listen me, example of cash discount. Suppose number one, rupees 1 lakhs of goods purchase at 10% trade discount and 10% cash discount. Here you see trade discount and cash discount both are given. But whenever trade discount given, value given in the transaction is considered as the artificial value. At first, from value given in transaction, trade discount deducted, and then we can get real value. Now, value given in transaction, 1 lakhs minus 10% trade discount. First of all, 10% of 1 lakhs will be 10,000. Now real value 90,000. You know, no accounting treatment of trade discount. Now here information given that rupees 1 lakhs of goods purchased at 10% trade discount and 10% cash discount. After deduction of trade discount. When we get real value, then cash discount chargeable on this real value. Now, minus discount always deducted, and therefore minus 10% cash discount. 10% of 90,000 will be 9,000, because cash discount chargeable on real value. 10% of 90,000 will be 9,000. Then cash payment 81,000. Now, triple effect. Now, triple effect of transaction. In fact, there are only two effects. I will teach you. Listen me. Here, 1 lakh of goods purchased at 10% rate discount and 10% cash discount. Now, goods purchased, that means goods comes in. How many rupees of goods comes in? Real value 90,000. Goods comes in 90,000 of goods comes in. 90,000 of goods comes in, but we paid 81,000 because cash discount charge rupees 9,000. 90,000 of goods purchased, but from this cash discount deducted 9,000. Therefore, cash payable, goods comes in, goods purchased, that means goods comes in, means cash payable. How much rupees cash payable? 81,000. After deduction of cash discount, cash goes out. Goods purchased 90,000, but cash paid 81,000. Instead of 90,000, we paid 81,000. Means our saving, our income of discount here 9,000. 90,000 of goods purchased, but we paid only 81,000. Our saving 9,000. It's the income of discount. Now, account includes goods comes in, goods and asset include in real account. Here, income of discount, income and expenditure also include in nominal account. And cash goes out. Cash means our asset. Asset and goods include in real account. Cash goes out. It's a matter of real account. Now, rule. First of all, real account, rule of real account, debit which comes in, credit which goes out, debit which comes in, credit which goes out, here goods comes in and therefore debited. Here nominal account, rule of nominal account, expenses are debited, incomes are credited. Here it's an income of discount, income must be credited, therefore credit. Cash goes out, real account. Rule of real account, debit which comes in, credit which goes out. Here, cash goes out and therefore credited. One item debited and two credited. Triple effect. Now, this is the first one, debited. Goods comes in, real account, debit. Goods account, debit. ऐसा नहीं लिखते हैं. क्या लिख सकते हैं हम? Purchase account. ये purchase है. Purchase account, debit. Value given here 90,000. Income of discount, nominal account, and therefore credited to discount account. How much rupees? 9,000. And here cash goes out, real account credited to cash account 81,000. Triple effect, one debit and two credit. No, it is not a triple effect, it is dual effect only. Dual effect calculated in amount, in rupees. You see, 90,000 debited and 90,000 credited. So, rule of accountancy, same amount debited and credited. You see, it's a double effect, not triple effect. In fact, Now, second one. ₹2 lakhs of goods sold at 10% rate discount and 10% cash discount. Now, here trade discount and cash discount both are given. Here name of person, cash were both are not given in both transaction. Therefore, both are cash transaction. And in cash transaction only, cash discount chargeable. Here, trade discount and cash discount both are given. First of all, trade discount deducted from value. Here value given 2 lakhs minus 10% trade discount. 10% of 2 lakhs will be 20,000. Now real value 1,80,000. No entry of trade discount. Now cash discount. Cash discount chargeable on real value means on 1,80,000, not on 2 lakhs. After deduction of trade discount in second step, cash discount chargeable minus 10% cash discount. 10% of 1,80,000 will be 18,000. 162,000. Yes. Now, triple effect. First one, goods sold. Goods goes out and real value of goods 1,80,000. This goods goes out. Goods goes out. 1,80,000 of goods goes out. Goods sold, real value 1,80,000. From this 10% cash discount charge. And therefore we received cash 1,62,000. Cash comes in. Here goods sold 1,80,000, but we received 1,62,000. Here less received 18,000. It's less received means our expense, our loss. Expense of discount. Now, accounts include goods goes out. Goods include in personal, real or nominal. It's a matter of nominal account. Goods goes out. Goods include in personal, real or nominal account. Goods and asset both include in real account. It's a matter of real account. Expense of discount. Expense and income include in nominal account. It's a matter of nominal. Here cash comes in. Cash means our asset. Asset include in real account. Now, rule. Real account first. Debit which comes in. Credit which goes out. Here goes out. Therefore, credited. Expense of discount, nominal account. Expenses are debited, incomes are credited. Here it's an expense and therefore debited. Cash comes in, real account. Debit which comes in, credit which goes out. Here cash comes in and therefore debited. Two items debited, one credited. First one debited, cash comes in, real account debited. Cash account debit. $1,62,000. Expense of discount, nominal account debited. Discount account debit. $1,80,000 goods goes out. It must be traded to goods account, not necessary to sales account. $1,80,000. Accounting treatment of cash discount. Now you know, I think, now you know all very well about cash discount and trade discount. Now today's homework after learning of these two transactions, one purchase, one sales with trade and cash discount. Now, practice work necessary. Homework for today's lecture. Journalize the following transaction. Rupees 10 lakhs of goods purchase at 10% trade discount and 10% cash discount. Number 2, rupees 20 lakhs of goods sold at 10% trade discount and 10% cash discount. Third one, rupees 30 lakhs of goods purchased at 10% trade discount and 5% cash discount. Number 4, rupees 40 lakhs of goods sold at 5% trade discount and 10% cash discount. This is your homework for today. ये सब बराबर लर्न करके इसकी प्रैक्टिस कीजिए. ट्रेड डिस्काउंट एंड कैश डिस्काउंट बोथ आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इन जर्नल एंट्री. इसमें आपकी मास्टरी आएगी आएगी. दोनों का बराबर अभ्यास करके इसकी प्रैक्टिस करनी है. और अगर कोई क्वेश्चन है तो कमेंट में आप लिख सकते हैं. ज्यादा से ज्यादा स्टूडेंट तक यह सब आप पहुंचाए और उसको घर बैठे एजुकेशन का लाभ दीजिए. थैंक यू वेरी मच.